Let the church say amen.
Amen.
me you can do better than let the church say amen again.
Amen.
Amen. Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord today?
Amen.
Oh, come on, don't fool me. Are you glad to be in God's house today?
Amen.
I am thankful for the way these students have conducted themselves today. They have done a phenomenal job, and I think we ought to affirm it by putting our hands together. And I am so thankful for whatever reason that they've asked me to come and share a little bit today. I'm glad to be back in Memphis. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
We made a journey early this morning. I'm coming over from Nashville. Kim and Kaylin send their love this afternoon. Kaylin has her Black History program at F.H. Jenkins be held at the Hillcrest Church today. And every year I have to speak away from Nashville on that day, they leave me high and dry. My daughter, for whatever reason, thinks I'm long-winded and I won't get her back in time. And so they leave me high and dry. As a matter of fact, one Sabbath, heading back from Greenwood, and I was actually going to make it on time. And when I came through Memphis, that was a snowstorm. And I got held up on the interstate on I-40 until Sunday morning. And when I did make it home, my daughter said, "This is why we don't go with you on Black History Weekend." This is our last year. How mature I am becoming, because my daughter is graduating eighth grade this year. And amen, I'm excited about that. And so we didn't want to force them, but glad to be here to hang out with you, to share just a little bit. And I am thankful for such an amazing pastor and first lady in the Hortons. Can we say amen? Come on, let's say amen. Amen. Pastor Horton is a very, very good friend of our family. Pastor, we love you, man. We always like hanging out with you. And there's something about freeing your schedule when you start talking about barbecue. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
The moment he announced it, we immediately went to our schedule and cancel the person they were supposed to be with on that Sabbath. Can I get a witness in this house? I mean, just conveniently canceled them and said, let's make our way back down here to be a part of what's happening. What do you call it? Memphis in May? Yeah, last Sabbath we were in Mobile, Alabama. And we kicked off our Touch 10,000. Somebody say Touch 10,000. And we are encouraging every member of our church to be involved in personal ministries. Come on, say amen. We believe that there are several ways that it can happen. And all of the churches in Mobile came together to include our church in Pensacola, Jordan Street. And it was Mardi Gras kickoff. And so we figured instead of having to run into the saints at Mardi Gras, come on, say amen. Y'all get quiet on me. We figured we would assist them. Come on, say amen. We figured we'd be a blessing to them. Come on, say amen. And in being a blessing to the saints, we will be a blessing to the community. Is that all right? And so we were able to go down and be a part of Mardi Gras. We had on our uniform, our Touch 10,000 t-shirts, Pastor. And we were able to be a blessing, to pray with people, to give water, to give food. It was just an amazing time. And to share our story of how God has richly blessed us. Everybody in here has a story. Come on, say amen. And the reason why it's quiet and the reason why you're acting very sophisticated right now is because you forgot your story. That's all right. You forgot from whence the Lord has brought you. Can I get a witness in here? You know you have a story, and the more you tell your story, the more you are committed to the God who gave you a story. Come on, say amen. Can I encourage you to tell your story this week? Come on, take the pious look off your face and tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord. Where the Lord found you. Boy, it's quiet in this house. What you were doing when he found you. Who you were with. It's getting quiet here, but that's all right. When he found you. But the good news is, he found you. Come on, say amen. Anybody in here glad that he found you? Can I give at least one witness in here, Allison? I promise you, I won't be long because I got to be back in time for this Black History program. So I won't be long. So just work with the short preacher. I'm realizing because I'm short, I'll be short. Is that all right? Some of the young people in the back were saying, oh man, man, camp meeting is just going to be different. No, it's not. It's going to be amazing this year. Come on, say amen. We're all going to rally behind to make sure that our young people still have an amazing time in Jesus Christ. Amen? I got a 14-year-old, and we want to make sure that our young people always see Jesus. Is that all right? Amen. Now, I'm going to get right to the word, and then I'll get on the road and get out of your hands. Is that all right? Father, this is not my moment, but this is your moment. This is not my day, but this is your day. These are not my children, but these children belong to you. These are not my people, but these people belong to you. And so, Lord, since you are in charge of it all, we want to hear from you. These few moments, speak to us and speak through us. And we'll be careful, give you the praise, the honor, and glory in Jesus' name. Let every heart say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen again.
Amen.
Amen. I know I have at least two more appointments to Longview Heights. One of them is the last Sabbath in May. Come on, say amen. You see, I just invited myself back. Come on, say amen. Amen. And this is home. I grew up in this federation. Amen. And Tad, you know, I can't, man, good to see you, man. But I can't be excited about the fact that I see very few of us who were here in the early 80s, we used to pack this place out for Federation. You remember that? So some of y'all here remember that. You know, I can't be excited. I'm thanking God for the young people and the generations that are coming. We have to make sure that we pour into them, keep them around. But we have indeed lost that group that hung out with us. I'm just talking about that group that hung out with us. I'm not even talking about the adults that were here during that time. And so my heart is aching for that group because I want to make sure that they connect with Jesus Christ and that they're saved in the kingdom. Who says amen? It is a challenge for me. It is it's the thing that's still waking me up in the middle of the night saying, what can we do, Ted? We got to do it. We cannot wait until somebody tells us we need to go. I'm challenging you, my brother. All right? Calling you out. I'm calling Felicia out. Amen. And I'm trying to find some more faces. Don't y'all stop ducking now. We're going to say amen. But we cannot be excited about the fact that we're here. We need to see our other family members. Come on, say amen. Amen. Good to see you in the back, Felicia. We got to go get them. Come on, say amen. And I believe God has given us this opportunity. I don't think everybody has to be a preacher to come back to church. Come on, say amen. Challenge that I have, you know, as a local pastor is that the only young adults I see are those who are getting ready to study for the ministry. that's the goal that I have as we use this vehicle that God has given us called Personal Ministries in South School. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Amen, amen, amen. So I know I have one appointment in May, but then Pastor, I'm on your calendar again. I don't know when it is, but it's before 2018. Come on, say amen. And we're going to talk about how we can get this generation back and involved in service for the kingdom. Come on, say amen. And I believe it looks a little different. Come on, say amen. Woo! Well, I lost my amen crowd already. You just say from the very beginning, I ain't scared of nobody. Come on, say amen. As short as I am, I ain't scared of nobody. Come on, say amen. I want to talk about your theme is fight. Come on, say amen. We're in the fight of our lives. Who believes that? And this morning, I want to talk about the real fight. Somebody say the real fight. Oh, you might as well talk to the preacher. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
The short preacher. It's okay, I'll come to the preacher. You see, I'm struggling to get this water. No, I gotta get water, so I gotta. Oh. Amen. Now the rest of y'all and get your deficiencies, you'll be alright too. Come on, say amen. The short preacher, that's it, wants to talk about the real fight. All right, look at your other neighbor this time and smile. Show two of your real good teeth. Don't show all of them. All right, fam, let me try to be obedient. Some of y'all showed everything in your mouth. Bring it down to two. And say the short preacher wants to talk about the real fight. You give me 20 minutes, I'll get out of your way. I like how the Bible pins it in the New International Version of the Bible, the real fight. For our struggle, if they could turn me down just a little bit, for our struggle is not against what, everybody? You gotta talk to me. Our struggle is not against what? But against the rulers, against the what? Against the what?
Thank you.
the issue and the challenge that I'm having is that we are fighting the wrong beat. We get out of our cars ready for a fight. Don't be quiet, that's all right. Ask them I'm running to my car. Come on, say amen. Before you can get in,
yeah. be quiet, that's all right. Oh, it's a fight. Oh, it's a real fight. In the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Just in California, 3 weeks ago, working on my doctoral program, and one of the pastors in that cohort, he is in a huge fight because he has a man who is married with children who has changed his identity, and now he wears a dress on Sabbath morning. Guess what? He's 7 days. Quiet him, that's all right. And because as a church, we have not been willing to have real conversations. Now our young people are sitting in this church and we see it. We know it's a challenge, but we're afraid because we've never addressed it. So we say, I'm praying for you, sweetie. Instead of praying with them, sweetie. Mm-hmm. Tell people, stop telling me you're praying for me. I know you're lying. It just sounds good. Hey, man, good to see you, preacher. Praying for you. Take some time to pray with me. Come on, say amen. Amen. The kind of stuff I'm talking about is overcoming challenging relationship with parents. Boy, y'all be quiet.
Yeah.
Masking depression!
Wow.
I experienced a real love. Anger. Come on, talk to me in this house. Resentment. The one that I do see, Ted. Angry. Because they got a child. Now be quiet, boy. That's all right. Church didn't know how to deal with them, with their child. He just wanted the child to be blessed. But it has to happen in the pastoral study. Just be quiet, boy. That's all right. Because we don't know how to demonstrate godly love. What last you seen God take somebody into a back room and bless their child? In Philadelphia, young lady walked up to me and said, if my church had disciplined me and loved me at the same time, I wouldn't have had 5 children in a row. Because God, you know what we're good at? We're good at sitting you down. But we ain't good at bringing you back. Discipling you. It's been quiet here. That's all right. And that's what my generation is. And it irks me to know that I got to be a preacher in order to actually be involved in church. Yeah, that's all black history. Come on, say amen. And you better hug my neck when I get to the door. Confusion. Acceptance. Where our young people now are doing all they can to be accepted, not by Jesus, but by their own parents. Because you didn't play the piano. Quiet, that's all right. You didn't go all the way through. Now you're going to make them do something that is not their God-given passion.
That's right.
Man, I just feel like asking the piano to play. Let's have closing prayer. Y'all mad at me already. I was just going to give a little lecture and then get back in my car and go home. But here's what I learned, though. We're actors on the wrong stage. If you give a preacher 5 more minutes, just raise your hand and give it 5 more minutes. I needed to keep that jacket on because, I mean, I'm hugging the shirt real good. Come on, say amen. Amen. I received that. But we're actors on the wrong stage. And I thought wrestling was real. I mean, Dr. Smith, good to see you, man. I thought for sure this was real stuff. I couldn't wait to see wrestling. Then my uncle dropped a bombshell on me. He said, nephew, you know they're just acting. They have decided before the match who's going to win. Their job is to entertain me for 30 to 45 minutes to say I had a real good show. You mean to tell me the winner's already decided? The problem is they're acting and we're not.
Wow.
They're all kind of fights. Be quiet, man. I'm almost done. I promise you. I told Caleb I can do this and be done by 1 o'clock. Come on, say amen. Y'all better tell her I finish on time. Come on, say amen. We got a problem. Somebody say
we got a problem.
Come on, look at your neighbor and say, you got a problem. Look at y'all and say, you really got a problem. So y'all so happy that I gave you permission to tell them that. Come on, say amen. You got a problem. We need H-E-L-P. We need some hope. Come on, say amen. I know it spells help, but we need some hope. Come on, say amen. We're fighting with the wrong people, taking people out. And we don't even care if we don't see them all. He wasn't committed anyway. Oh, not to your foolishness. Come on, say amen. And if God is like you not acting, I don't want nothing to do with him or that church. It's quiet as house. Jesus, help. Come on, say amen. Somebody shout help. Because here's what Paul says, and then I'll take my seat. Paul decides to tell my story because so many of you all are too sophisticated to tell the truth yourself. And so I'll just read my story to you from Paul. Come on, say amen. Here's what he says from the Message, Romans 7, 14 through 25. Pastor, I promise y'all say that. Is that all right? Here's what he says. I can anticipate the response that is coming. I know that all God's commands are what, everybody? Y'all stay with me. I won't be much longer. But I'm not. Don't look around. It's my story. Come on, say amen. I love it. I'm full of myself. He says, I realize I don't have what it takes. Oh, don't be quiet with me now. Come on, say amen. I'm just reading the Bible. Come on, say amen. It's my story, so say amen to my story. Come on, say amen. He says, I can will it, but I can't do it. He says, I decide to do good, but I don't really do it. I decide not to do bad, but then I do it anyway. Say, I'm gonna cuss him out. God kept my tongue 7 days. Come on, say it.
Most That's when the enemy, he turns on the heat.
Yes.
But it ain't got nothing to do with you.
That's right.
He's trying his best, not dying, to convince Jesus that we don't really love him.
We only serve him because of what he does for us.
Or help me with my 300 credit score. Stop looking at your feet. Come on, say it. I just counted 8 people with 300 credit score. Come on, say it.
Help me
to get approved. You're talking about
my young people, my young adults, my mature people, we've never heard of the gospel. All we know is law. How's that been working for you? If I do, it's gonna get quiet here, but that's all right. If I do, and we do ourselves right to hell, feeling guilty when we don't. You know I'm telling the truth. I gotta make sure I do this. And you and I have got to the point where we've done all of our doing, and we're not much closer to our relationship with Jesus Christ than when we first started. The only, hear me, family, today, the only thing that saves us is Jesus. Period. Okay, how many Sabbaths do you think you have kept? Because you don't even know how to keep Sabbath. Before sun goes down, you've talked about any and everything. Don't rush me, I ain't done yet. we're in a wrestle. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
We're in a fight. I love this. I love this, guys. We're in a struggle. The great controversy is not about us. It's over us. Jesus wants us, but he only wants us if we love him. He won't force himself on us. That's only for young people who love Jesus. You love him, and you want to do whatever he says. Be quiet in him. That's all right. I love him so much. He wants me to remember Saturday and keep holy. I love him. I hate dishes. I hate him with a passion. I'd rather walk by the sink with the dishes piled all the way to the ceiling. I hate him that much. Kim said,
real people.
Stop looking at your feet. Stop looking at your hands. Stop saying in your mind, he ain't talking to me. I'm not. But the Spirit of God is talking to me. In a fight, a real fight, a wrestle, a struggle. God is saying, I love you. I love you. And I'm calling you back to me, to a love relationship. You understand that this fight?
Needs to stick to preaching and teaching. and you're gonna miss out on that. To fight somebody. I don't know, Pastor. I don't know if that's Advent we should be doing that. What is what you gonna do? I don't know, man. We ain't quite ready for that. You've been saying that for 40 years.
Father,
scary stories. You don't want people serving you out of fear. You want us to serve you out of love. So today, Father, I pray that you give them another opportunity. Don't wipe them out. Prevent the accidents. Dial back the trouble that seems to be coming. So they can say yes out of a heart of love, not out of fear. Then, Father, pray for the angel of this house that you have sent here. Pastor Horton, and pray a special prayer for Deborah right now. That you not be God, we know you are God in her life, but that you will remain God in her life. Then I pray, Father, that you surround this pastoral family with people who are willing, as he is willing to follow you, they're willing to follow him as well. I believe, God, thank you so much, that you're getting ready to do some stuff at Longview. That is, in fact, God breathed. The moment the enemy rears his ugly head to try to pick a fight, you're going to give the people of God power and authority to call the enemy by his name. This church is going to move forward for you. Bless the young people in this place. Save us now, not when you come. Save us now. So when you come, we'll be with you for eternity in Jesus' name. Come on, if you receive this word today, then you say amen. Come on, say amen again. Amen. If you're not to me, put your hands together, give the Lord a hand. God bless you. Those with the raised hand. Pastor Horton wants to see you at the end of this service. Make sure you come down, connect with him today. Help somebody on your way back to your seat. God bless you.